So now the new topic of chapter number 7, it is section formula. So before learning the section formula, so what is the section formula? So first of all, here we are taking 2 points. Suppose it is 1, 2 and it is 3, 5. A and B. We can declare A it is 1, 2 and B is equal to 3, 5. Now I want to take a point P which is not a equidistance. Clear? Which is a not a equidistance from A as well as B. And this point divide this line into two different sections. Clear? This point divide this line into the two different sections. Suppose these both are equal, so it is known as a midpoint. Clear? So it is known as a midpoint. But sometime the possibility is also like that. Suppose I am taking a P here. So it means what? This distance, so we can divide this AB into the two different sections. So we can declare it is 1, 2. And if it is midpoint, so it means what? 1, 1. Clear? So it means what? If we have a 2 points and we are joining these 2 points, so it means what? The P is a point which divides these 2 points into the different section. Clear? Either 1, 1, 3, 2 or 5, 7, like that. Clear? So it is known as a section point. Clear? So it is this point divide this line into the different section. Suppose this section, sometime it is 1 means what? M1. Value of M1 it is 1 and value of M2 it is 2. So it is M1, M2. Clear? We can say that what? M1, M2 is equal to 1, 2. So value of M1 it is 1 and value of M2 it is 2. So it is known as a ratio. M1 upon M2 is equal to 1/2. Clear? It is a 1/2. So now if I want to find out the coordinate of this point P, so how can we find the coordinate of point P? So we have one formula. Clear? So coordinate of a point x, y, so it is our point P, x, y means, which divide the line segment of A as well as B. So we have a 2 point and we want to find out the coordinate of P. So we have the formula like that: m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. Here m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. So this is our point P. m1 means what? Ratio. m1 m2 means what? Ratio. x2 means what? Coordinate of B. x1 means coordinate of A. Similarly for coordinate y coordinate of B, and this is a y coordinate of A. Clear? So by if the value is given, so if we here we can put the all the value in this formula, so we can find the answer of our coordinate P. So this is known as our section formula. Clear? This is known as our section formula. Sometime what happen? Ratio is given like k gem 1. So it means k means what? m1 upon m2. We can sometime also write like that, k. Clear? m1 upon m2. We can also write like k. So formula becomes like that: kx2 plus x1 upon k plus 1 is equal to ky2 plus y1 upon k plus 1. So it means what? If ratio is given in m1 gem m2, so we are using this formula. And ratio is given in k gem 1, so at that time we are using this formula. So you need to remember this formula So this formula name is what? Suction formula. Clear? Exercise 7.2, question number 1. So this all exercises depend on our suction formula. Clear? So here first question, find the coordinate of point which divide a joint of -1,7 and -4,-3 in the ratio of 2:3. So first of all, we can draw the one line. It is A and it is B. What is A? We can declare -1,7 it is our point A and 4,3 is our point B. And here one point is divide this all line into which section? 2:3. So it is 2 part and it is 3 part. So we need to find the coordinate of P. Here we need to find the coordinate of P. So here we are applying suction formula. Coordinate of P is equal to, what is its formula? m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2. Similarly for y, m1 plus m2. So now next, what is m1? So it is m1 is 2, it is m1 and it is m2. Here it is x1 and y1 and this is called x2 and y2. Now m1, so what is the value of m1? 2, x2, so it is 4 plus m2, 3, x1 minus 1 upon m1 plus m2, so 2 plus 3, here we can also write 2 plus 3. Now m1, 2, what is y2? Minus 3, m2, so 3, y1, it is 7. Now simplify that. So 4 2's are 8, plus minus minus, 3 1's are 3, 2 plus 3 5. Next, 3 2's are minus 6, 7 3's are 21, 3 plus 2 5. Next, 8 minus 3, so 5 upon 5, 21 minus 6, so it is 15 upon 5. 5 5 cut, 5 3's are. So what is our point of P? It is 1,3. So this point divide this all line into which ratio? 2:3. Now next, question number 2. Find the coordinate of point of trisection. Here see that trisection means what? One line divide into the 3 different sections. And 2 points are given. So first of all, we can draw the line AB. A is equal to 4,-1 and B is equal to -2,-3. So trisection means what? 1 and 2. So here see that one part, it is second and it is third. So trisection here 1, 2 and 3. Clear? If they are asking trisection, so one line divide into the 3 equal sections, first, second and third. So first of all, we can find the point P. Clear? Here we need to find the value of, first of all we need to find the value of coordinate of P. So how can we find the coordinate of P? We can declare it is x, y. So here it is a one part, so 1, and this is our 2 part. So it means what? It is a value of m1 and it is a value of m2. If you want to find out the value of P, so it means what? This, if I want to find out that point, so it is 1 and it is 2 part, so 1:2. What is our ratio? It is 1:2. Now we are applying suction formula, so we can write coordinate of P What is its formula? M1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2, m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. Now next, what is m1? 1 x2, so it is x2 y2, and this is our x1 y1. So what is x2? Minus 2 m2, it is 2. What is x1? 4 upon 1 plus 2, here 1 plus 2 because m1 and m2, m1 value is 1 and m2 value is 2. So 1 y2 minus 3 m2 y1, it is minus 1. Now simplify that. 2 minus 2, 4 2 is 8 upon 3, here 3, 3 1 is minus 3 plus plus minus once again minus 2. So what is our answer? 8 minus 2, 6 by 3, minus 5 by 3. So 3 1s are, 3 2s are. So what is the coordinate of P? 2 comma minus 5 by 3. So it is a point of 2 comma minus 5 by 3. It is a coordinate of P. Now we want to also the find out the coordinate of Q because of trisection. So if you want to find out the trisection, now we want to find out the value of Q, coordinate of Q. So here we can write coordinate of Q. So once again same formula, m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2, m1 y2 plus m2 y1 upon m1 plus m2. Value of x1 y1 and x2 y2 will be remain same, but the ratio is changed. How? See that Q point is here, so it is a one part. We can use the different chalk so you haven't get idea. See that it is our first part and this is our second part. So it is 1 and it is 2. So what is the value of m1? 2. And what is the value of m2? It is 1. Clear? Now next. So m1. So what is the value of m1? 2. X2. It is minus 2. M2. 1. X1. It is 4. Upon 2 plus 1, here once again 2 plus 1. Next, m1 is same. What is y2? Minus 3. M2 1. What is y1? It is minus 1. Now simplify that. So 2 2s are minus 4 upon 3, and 4 1s are 4. Here minus 6 and 1 1 is plus minus minus. So 4 minus 4, 0 by 3, minus 7 by 3. So what is the coordinate of Q? 0 comma 7 by 3. So it is clear, 0 comma minus 7 by 3. So it is our question number second. Now next question, question number 3. To conduct a sport day activity in your rectangle shape school ground. See that our school ground is in rectangle shape. A, B, C and D. Line have been drawn with the chalk powder. So here we can draw the line. At the distance of 1 meter each. So see that here 1 meter each. This distance is 1 meter. And 100 flower pot has been placed at the distance of 1 meter from each other along with AD. So this is our AD line. And here we can put the 100 flower pot. Clear? Here we can at the 1 meter distance, here we can put 100. So it means what? The distance of AD, it is 100 meter. Clear? Distance of AD, it is 100 meter. Now next, Niharika runs 1/4 of the distance AD. So here AD on the second line. So Niharika run on second line, and he what distance he is far away from the starting point? 1/4 of AD. So the total line, it is 100 meter, and Niharika run what? 1/4 of the AD. So 1/4 of the 100, clear? Because this distance of AD, it is 100. So 1/4 of the 100, Niharika reach at that point. And second, and post a green flag. So here they are posting a green flag. Now next, Preet run the 1/5 distance of AD. So Preet, so this cover, Niharika cover 1/4 distance, and Preet cover 1/5 of AD. And they on the 8th line. So Preet is on which line? 8th line. And post a red flag. So they are posting a red flag. Now next, so what is the distance between both flag? So we need to find what is the distance between these two points. So first of all, we want to find out the coordinate for Niharika as well as coordinate for a Preet. So for, see that, so it is our x and this is our y. So Niharika run on second line. So what is its x coordinate to? Clear? So here we can write coordinate of Niharika. So we can declare it is n. So what is its x coordinate? She is run on second line, so 2. And they are covering how much distance? 1/4 of AD. So what is its y coordinate? 1/4 of AD. So n is equal to 2, 1/4 of AD. So 1/4 into 100. So 4 here, 25. So what is its coordinate? 2, 25. Now same for a Preet. Coordinate of Preet P. So Preet run on a 8 line. So here 8. And he cover how much distance? 1/5 of AD. So it means what? 8, 1/5 into 100. So here 20. So what is its coordinate? 8, 20. And for a Preet, we can take a P. So we need to find what is the we need to find the NP. Clear? Here we need to find the distance NP. So here we are using distance formula, x2 minus x1 all square plus y2 minus y1 all square. So what is x2? 8 minus 2 all square plus 20 minus 25 all square. Simplify this. 8 minus 2, 6, 6 square, it is 36. 20 minus 25, so minus 5, minus 5 square, it is plus 25. So 36 plus 25, so 5 plus 11, 61. So what is the distance between Preet and Niharika? It is under root 61 meter. Clear? Under root 61 meter. Now next, they are also asking, see that if Rashmi has a post a blue flag exactly the halfway between the line segment. So here this is our line, and Rashmi post exactly between this line. Here Rashmi want to post a flag between the line segment joining the two flags. So where should she post her flag? So it means what? We need to find the coordinate of for a Rashmi. So here we can declare R. So see that it is a midpoint of N and P. Clear? They are saying that what? Exactly the halfway. Word See that word, exactly the halfway. So we need to find the midpoint of N and P. So here we have one formula for that. The midpoint of N P is equal to x1 plus x2 divided by 2 and y1 plus y2 divided by 2. So what is the coordinate of N? 2. X2, it is 8 divided by 2. Then y1, 25. Y2, 20 divided by 2. Simplify this, 8 plus 2, 10. 45 by 2. So 5. So what is its coordinate? 5 comma and 45. So it is 22.5. Clear? So it means what? Rashmi, it is on a fifth line. Clear? 5 means what? Rashmi post on the fifth line. And what is its distance? 20, from here, it is 22.5. Question number 4. Find the ratio in which the line joining the point. So here we have a one line. So this point, it is minus 3 comma 10. And this is B, 6 comma minus 8. Is divided by, so here the coordinate of P is also given, but we need to find the ratio M1 and M2. Clear? We can also declare like that K M1 upon M2 is equal to, also we can write like that K upon 1. So here in this example, we are going to use our second formula of section formula. So how can we apply that formula? So first of all, we can write like that, coordinate of P is equal to kx2 plus x1 upon k plus 1, ky2 plus y1 upon k plus 1. So it is our second formula. What is the coordinate of P? It is given minus 1 comma 6. K is as usual. What is it? Is x1 y1, this is x2 y2. What is x2? 6 plus x1, it is minus 3 upon k plus 1 comma k. What is y2? 8. What is y1? 10. Now simplify. So 6k minus 3 upon k plus 1. And here minus 8k plus 10 upon k plus 1. Now compare both sides. So what is x coordinate? Comparing both sides. So minus 1 is equal to, what is its x coordinate? 6k minus 3 upon k plus 1. And second, minus 6 is equal to minus 8k plus 10 upon k plus 1. Solve either of one, because in both cases we can get the same answer. So we can solve our first. So minus 1. So this k plus 1 is going second side. So it will be the multiplication with a minus 1 is equal to 6k minus 3. So minus k minus 1 is equal to 6k minus 3. Now this minus k is going second side. So it become plus. So here we can write like that, minus 1, and this minus 3 is going second side, so it become plus 6k, and here it is plus k. Clear? So now what is its simplification? 6 plus 1, 7k is equal to 3 minus 1, so it is 2. So what is k? 2 by 7. So it means, what is our ratio? M1 gem M2 is equal to 2 upon 7, or also we can write like that, M1 gem M2 is equal to 2 gem 7. Clear? So it is our ratio. If you are solving about this case, so in this case we can get the same answer. Clear? Now next, question number 5. Find the ratio in which the line segment joining is, suppose this is our line A and b 1 comma minus 5 and here minus 4 comma 5. So it is x1 y1 and it is our x2 y2. Line segment joining, it is divided by x axis. So x axis means what? If we draw in the rough, so you can get the idea. Suppose it is our line. So here it is x, it is on x axis. So it means what? Its y coordinate becomes 0. Clear? It y coordinate become 0. So first of all we can find the ratio, and then we can also find the coordinate of division. So it means the value of the coordinate of P. So once again we have the same, we are applying the same formula. Coordinate of P is equal to k x2 plus x1 upon k plus 1 is equal to k y2 plus y1 upon k plus 1. What is coordinate of P? It is x comma 0. Here k, what is x2? Minus 4 x1 1 upon k plus 1. What is y2? 5 y1 minus 5 upon k plus 1. Now compare both side. Comparing both side, so x is equal to minus 4k plus 1 upon k plus 1, x coordinate with x and y coordinate with y. So 0 is equal to 5k minus 5 upon k plus 1. So this k plus 1 is multiplying with 0, cross multiplication. So 0, this minus 5 is going second side, so it become plus 5. So what is the value of k? 5 upon 5. So it will be cut. So it means what? 1. Now put this value in this equation. We can declare it is 1 in equation number 1. So here k is replaced with 1. So minus 4 plus 1 upon 2. So it is minus 3 by 2. Clear? So what is the coordinate of P now? Minus 3 by 2 comma 0. So ratio is 1 gem 1. And what is the coordinate of P? It is minus 3 by 2 comma 0. So question number 6. If 1 comma 2, 4 comma y, x comma 6 and 3 comma 5 are the vertices of a parallelogram taken in order, so find the value of x and y. So here parallelogram, so we can declare it is A, B, C and D. So we have two diagonal AC and BD. So here you need to remember the one of the property of parallelogram. The property is like that, diagonal of parallelogram always intersect each other. So see that these both are intersecting at point O. So O means what? Midpoint of BD as well as midpoint of AC. So here we can write like that, the midpoint of AD is equal to the midpoint of AC and BD, because AC and BD. So what is its formula? X1 plus X2 divided by 2 is equal to Y1 plus Y2 divided by 2. Similarly here, X1 plus X2 divided by 2 and Y1 plus Y2 divide with 2. So here AC, this point, clear? Here we are using different chalk, so you can get the idea. So it is X1 and Y1 and this is X2, Y2 if we are considering AC. So what is X1? 1. What is X2? It is X divide with 2. Y1 plus Y2, so 2 plus 6 divide with 2. Now here BD, so it is BD. So once again it is X1 Y1 and it is X2 Y2. So what is X1? 4 What is x2? 3 divide with 2 is equal to. What is y1? It is y. What is y2? 5 divide with 2. Now we can compare both side. Comparing both side. So 1 plus x divide with 2 is equal to. What is its x coordinate? 4 plus 3 divide with 2. And what is its y? 2 plus 6 divide with 2 is equal to y plus 5 divide with 2. So 2 is cut from both sides. And 4 plus 3 it is 7. And this one is going second side, so it become minus. So what is its, what is the value of x? It is 6. Here once again 2 cut. So 6 plus 2 8. So and this pi is going second side, so it become minus. So what is the value of y? It is 3. Now next, last question number 7. Find the coordinate of point A where AB is a diameter of a circle. So first of all we can draw the circle. So it is our circle and they are saying AB is its diameter. So here it is A and it is B. Whose center is given? See that center is given. So we can declare it is 2 comma minus 3. And B point is also given, 1 comma 4. So they are asking find the coordinate of A. So it means we need to find the coordinate of A. So center is a midpoint of AB in a circle. Center is midpoint of AB. So we can write like that. Here we can declare it is O. So the coordinate of O is equal to x1 plus x2 divided with 2 is equal to y1 plus y2 divided with 2. So what is the coordinate of O? It is given 2 comma minus 3. X1, it is x. What is x2? 1. What is x2? Sorry, y1. So it is y. Y2, 4 divided with 2. Now comparing both sides. So 2 is equal to x plus 1 divided with 2. And minus 3 is equal to 4 y plus 4 divided with 2. So these 2 is going second set, so 2 2s are 4. Now this one is going second set, so it become minus. So what is its x coordinate? It is 3. Now similarly for y, so 3 2s are 6 and this 4 is going second set, so it become minus. So it is minus 10. So it means what is the coordinate of A? 3 comma minus 10. Question 8, if A and B are the given, so A and B are given, A and B, minus 2 minus 2 and it is 2 comma minus 4. Respectively, find the coordinate of P such that, so P is here and we need to find its coordinate x comma y. AP is given, 3 gem. AP is equal to 3 by 7 AB and P lies on the line segment AB. So it means what? AP is equal to 3 by 7 AB. AP is equal to 3 by 7 AB. So PB is equal to 4 by 7 AB because here 3 and 4, so 4 plus 3 7. Clear? 4 plus 3 is 7. So it means what? AP and PB, it is 3 gem 4. AP gem PB is equal to 3 gem 4. So ratio is given M1 and it is M2. Now we want to find out the coordinate of P. So we are using our section formula. So the coordinate of P is equal to m1 x2 plus m2 x1 upon m1 plus m2 comma m1 y2. So it is our section formula. Now put the value. What is m1? 3. It is x2 y2 and this is x1 y1. So what is x2? 2. m2 4. What is x1? Minus 2 upon m1 plus m2. So 3 plus 4. Here we can also write 3 plus 4. What is y2? Minus 4. m2, it is 4. y1, so it is minus 2. Simplify that. 3 2 is 6 plus minus minus 4 2 is 8 upon 7. 4 2 is 4 3 is 4 3 is minus 12 plus minus minus 4 2 is 8 upon 7. 6 minus 8, so minus 2 upon 7 minus 20 upon 7. So what is the coordinate of P? It is minus 2 by 7 and minus 20 by 7. Next, question number 9. Find the coordinate of point which divide the line segment. So here one line is given. A, this is B. A is minus 2 comma 2 and it is 2 comma 8 into 4 equal parts. So we need to divide this line into 4 equal parts. So here font, see that 1, 2, 3 and 4 part. So first of all, here we can declare it is P, this coordinate is Q and this coordinate is R. So Q is a midpoint of AB and P, so it is one part. Here we are using different, so see that. So it is 1, so it is 3 part. It is 3 part, clear, 1 gem 3. So next, so m1 and it is m2 and x1 y1 and this is x2 y2. So we can write like that, coordinate of P is equal to section formula m1 x2 m2 x1 m1 plus m2 m1 y2 plus m2 y1. So what is m1? 1. X2, 2. M2, it is 3. What is x1? X1, it is minus 2 upon m1 plus m2. What is y2? 8. Y1, it is 2. Simplify this. 2 1s are 2 plus minus minus 3 2s are 6. 8 6 upon 4. So what is the coordinate of P? 2 minus 6, so minus 4 upon 4. 8 plus 6, 14 upon 4. So 4 4 cut, here 2s are 7s are. So minus 1 upon 7 by 2. So it is the coordinate of P. Now we want to find out the coordinate of Q. So see that this is 2 part. Once again this is 2 part. So it is a midpoint. So how can we find the coordinate of Q? Coordinate of Q is equal to x1 plus x2 divided by 2. Because here we are using Q is a midpoint. Clear? Q is a midpoint of AB. So what is its formula to find out the midpoint? X1 plus x2 divided with 2 and y1 plus y2 divided with 2. What is x1? Minus 2. X2 plus 2. Y1, 2 plus a divided with 2. So 2 minus 2, 0. 0 upon 2, so 0. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 by 2, so it is 5. Now next, last. Now we want to find out the coordinate of R. So if you want to, so it is one part. and this is our three part. So 3m1, clear? m1 is m1 m2 is equal to 3m1. So now we can write coordinate of r is equal to, once again section formula, m1 x2, so it is our section formula. Now put the value of each. m1 is 3, x2 2, 1, x1 minus 2 upon 3 plus 1, y2 8, y2 is 8, y1 it is 2, now simplify this, 3 2s are 6, plus minus minus, 8 3s are 24, 2 upon 4, so 6 minus 2, 4 by 4, here 26 by 4, so 4 4 cut, 1, here 2, so here 13, so 13 by 2, so what is the coordinate of R? It is 1 comma 13 by 2, so here if, so in this we have the three types of the example. If they are dividing the two equal parts, so we are going to apply the midpoint formula. And if they are asking divide this line into the trisection, so we need to divide the three equal parts. If they are using four equal parts, so here we are dividing this line into the four equal parts. Sometimes they are also asking divide into the five equal parts, clear? So similarly we can use for a 5 point also. Now last sum, question 10, find the area of rhombus. So rhombus is in which shape? We can declare A, B, C and D. So what is the coordinate of A? It is given 3, 0, 4, 5, minus 1, 4 and minus 2, minus 1. So it is a rhombus. Rhombus means all sides are equal. So they are asking find the area of rhombus. Area of rhombus. And they are giving us a hint. Area of rhombus is equal to 1 by 2 product of diagonal. So we have a two diagonal, AD and BC. So it means what? 1 by 2 AC into BD. So first of all we need to find the value of AC. So here we are going to use our distance formula. So AC, so minus 1 minus 3 all square, then 4 minus 0 all square, so minus 4, so 16, 4, 16, so it is under root 32, clear? It is under root 32. Now next BD, once again we are applying section formula. BD, minus 2 minus 4, minus 1 minus 5, so simplify this, 6, once again 6, so 36 plus 36, so it is 72. So here we can also write like that, 36 2s are, so 36 2s are, it means what is the square root of 36? 6 root 2. Here once again we can write like that, 16 2s are, so what is the square root of 16? 4 root 2, clear? Now we are applying our formula, area of rhombus is equal to 1 by 2 AC into BD. 1 by 2, what is AC? 4 root 2 into BD, 6 root 2, so root 2 into root 2, it is only 2 because 2 times root 2, so these 2, 2 cut, 6 4s are 24, Clear? 6 4s are 24.